estate in this market can be tough. Even high-end apartments need help, so some people turn to professional stagers. I'm Kelsey Hubbard here on Park Avenue at a luxury building where we're going to see how it's done. Come on, let's check it out. So we're here at this Park Avenue penthouse apartment, and we're going to talk to Cheryl Eisen of Interior Marketing Group to tell us how she staged this apartment to move. Come on, let's go meet her. Hi, Cheryl.
Hi, Kelsey.
How are you? Kelsey Hubbard.
Nice to meet you.
Wow, great apartment.
Welcome to the penthouse.
So this is an interesting dynamic for a lot of people who aren't used to selling high-end real estate and this idea of staging an apartment. So tell us what you do.
Well, basically, most apartments we stage are empty. They've been on the market for a while, unsold, no offers, and we come in and transform them into livable, luxurious homes.
All right, so tell us what you did. Here we're going to start in this dining area, which is right off when you walk in the door.
This is actually just an empty gallery, and the owner had it just as an art gallery. There was no functionality to it, which I think inhibits a sale because you want to see every space if you're paying for it, you know, and how you can function in it. So we made it into a formal dining area.
All right, so take us through the living room and why you added some of the pieces that you did here and what would appeal to the potential buyer of this home.
Well, this is a very luxurious sofa. It's a like $13,000 sofa. So it's very, you know, and it's white, so it sort of blends in. It doesn't take you away from the beauty of the room. I also love, obviously, to add tons of mirrors because, you know, it makes it feel much more spacious and light.
And are all these items very expensive, or could people go and buy some of these to add to what they have already existing in their apartment just to make it nicer for a sale?
You know, you'd be surprised. What we do is we add inexpensive items, like all of these mirrors, believe it or not, are from IKEA. With expensive items like the sofa and this coffee table and the Jonathan Adler stuff.
Right.
And then other things are from like Daffy's, believe it or not, like that console there.
So it's a mix of high and low.
It is a mix, and you know what? You'd never know if you really have high-end stuff with low-end stuff.
A lot of high-end luxurious apartments in New York have outdoor space, which needs staging as well. So you've come out here to this terrace. Tell us what you've done here to make it a livable space.
Well, this terrace, it's gorgeous already. It had all these wonderful trees and plants, but there was nothing else. It was just, you know, the ground. So we brought in a beautiful lounge, and when you put like outdoor carpeting and tables, it feels like you can really lounge out here and read a book. It's more cozy and comfy.
So people can envision how they would use their outdoor space.
Exactly, or you picture a party at night here. But also there's a level of comfort when you come out here. I wouldn't want like a dining scene. I like a cozy, comfy, you know, outdoor lounge.
And if people ever come to you and say, you know, once you've staged it, they're like, I like the way it looks, I want to buy all this furniture from you?
Surprisingly, that happens. And the place doesn't sell, the people just take their apartment back. It sells to the seller.
Have you ever had a situation where no matter what you've done to an apartment, it just hasn't sold?
Not yet, thank goodness.